Honorable Chief Minister Shri K. Chandrasekhar Rao Garu, Honorable Industry Minister, Honorable Ministers from the Cabinet, Excellencies representing foreign missions in India, distinguished leaders and captains of the industry, representatives of industry, people's representatives, my colleague officers, and all the distinguished guests present in the meeting today. Let me extend a very warm welcome to all of you, and let me say that we are proud to be a part of this momentous occasion when the new state of Telangana has completed its 1 year and this industrial policy is being launched, and we are all a witness to this event. We are also proud to be a part of the new and resurgent India. We are proud to be part of the new ethos of Make in India, and we want to be in it wholeheartedly, and with the support of you all, I'm sure we'll succeed. As you all know, young Telangana state came into being on 2nd June, and right from that day onwards, under the able and dynamic leadership of our Chief Minister, we have been formulating policies with a strategy in mind, be it social welfare, industrial development, economic development, or issues pertaining to urban growth and rural development. With these objectives in mind, the government has taken up many flagship schemes to bring the state on the growth trajectory where we are aiming at a growth which is unprecedented. To name a few things, let me mention that in power sector, this year alone, we are going to add from the present level of 4,300 megawatt or so, 3,000 megawatt extra capacity to see that this state is rid of not only power cuts, but in future, it becomes a power surplus state. There is a plan to add another 24,000 megawatt by the time we reach 2018. Water is another area which always creates problems in industrialization and also in day-to-day lives of people, when drinking water also becomes a survival issue. I am proud to share with you that Telangana state has started, and work has already started on this scheme, which is known as Telangana Water Grid. We are spending more than 30,000 crores on this scheme, and the good news here is that 10% of the water from this will be provided for the industry. It will be earmarked for them. Coming to another issue, which is another necessary ingredient for any industry to be set up, that is land, which is a scarce commodity, a finite commodity. Telangana is blessed with certain huge parcels of government land which were hitherto uncared for. We have identified those and created a land bank which comprises of 1,50,000 acres of land which is meant only for industrial use, and Telangana State Industrial Development Corporation, Industrial Infrastructure Corporation, will be the custodian of these lands, and we are also going to include this in the whole policy which will be unfolding before you in a few minutes. Skilled resources, as you all know, Hyderabad and the state of Telangana, particularly the region surrounding Hyderabad, they have large presence of technical institutions which are of good quality. We have both national level institutions as well as those which have been nurtured by the state. these institutions produce very good quality of engineers, and quality being the foremost in our mind, the government has been very strict in terms of permitting those colleges which only pass the muster in terms of the benchmarks which we have set out for them in terms of quality standards. Ease of doing business is what is required to promote the entrepreneurship, to attract the investment and the industry. And this is what precisely we are going to do through this industrial policy, which is process oriented, where the chances of discretion being applied by anyone are totally eliminated. This is a policy which is transparent, which provides a right to entrepreneurs to set up business here. So in terms of ease of doing businesses, it is something which is a novel idea. And just to give you an example without going into detail, we are also providing a provision where if any officer of the government delays anything by even one day, he or she would be fined ₹1,000 per day on a recurring basis. There was a presentation here in the brief film which you saw, city improvement, because anyone who comes here must be in an environment which is a world standard. And with that thing in view, Hyderabad itself is going to have a lot of improvement, both in terms of ease of traffic and civic amenities, as well as things like housing for all, including particularly the poor people.